Would you like to introduce yourself?
Dr. Grant Ellis, holder of PhDs in psychology and parapsychology with a master's in physiology.
My name is Dr. David Archer. I have a degree in biology with emphasis on neurology.
Let me start by saying this. It is extremely likely that a zombie apocalypse or an end of the world scenario featuring zombies could take place.
Toxoplasma gondii is this really gnarly brain virus. Toxoplasma gondii can only breed inside the intestines of a cat. So it will then infect a rat, and it causes the rat to seek out cats and basically be a little tasty treat.
Let's begin with talking about toxoplasmosis. We use such a disease in our rats at our facilities and laboratory testing.
Basically, what they tested was the difference between rats without toxoplasmas and rats with it. What they found was that in putting it in a captive situation and dousing things with cat urine, they deducted the fact that, you know, most rats would run from the cat urine, and with the ones that are infected, they look for it again and again and again. They seek out the cat.
A variant, a mutant of this virus can infect a human. Loss of rational thought and muscle control, reducing a human to their most prime and basic instincts. They become nothing but a ravaging, thrashing ignoramus, and it would be bad. It would be bad.
So this toxoplasma gets into their brain? The rat no longer?
The rat is no more. Once the toxoplasmus infects a host, it lights out. Mad cow disease. It's not very pretty. Okay, for instance, this totally and completely gentle creature suddenly becomes infected with mad cow disease. What it does is it infects its cerebral cortex and it goes buck wild. Its aggression skyrockets. Perfect example, 28 days later. Here you have this normal society, everything's quiet, and with the flip of a switch, you have this virus, this infection that just engulfs everything in its path.
Well, it doesn't sound that bad to me either. It didn't sound that bad to me until I heard of Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. It's a variant of mad cow that would infest a human. There would be muscle spasming, twitching, biting of one's own flesh, and feasting upon human organs. The evolution of the mad cow in a string of the virus that would infect humans, it would just lead to the total downfall of civilization as we know it. It would spread rapidly. It would be airborne. It would also be found in our food. Just relatives shaking hands could cause transmission of this disease. In a few years, you'll notice the nanobot technology where microscopic computers basically can infest a human. It can take over their thoughts and all muscle function. Basically, you would be able to be controlled by these parasitic devices. The technology has already been developed. It's already been tested. I personally was involved in several experiments through the use of nanotechnology, and the results were terrifying. Complete reprogramming of the brain. You've reprogrammed a computer before. You've asked a computer to do certain things. Think of the brain of the human brain as an ultimate supercomputer. The nanobots can reprogram this ultimate supercomputer and use it for whatever use it wants. We're talking about complete destruction of human race as we know it.
So what are any last words you want to say to people who would listen, would actually listen?
I'd have to say, if you know of a really good handy shop with, let's say, knives, guns, I would have to say you get there as quick as you possibly can. You make connections, you make friends, you make sure they like you, and you just pray to God that you don't end up dead. Snack witch.
Pray. Just pray. Science won't save you.
There's no escaping from the virus. All you can do is fight, and at some point you're gonna lose. And that's the ultimate design.